Hello, this is Vic. Welcome to my channel and thank you for viewing my videos. Today I'm in the beautiful and historic country of Germany and I'm visiting the city of Nuremberg. I'm actually around 4 kilometers southwest from the center of the medieval town of Nuremberg. In this particular documentary, we're going to visit the site where the National Socialist Party held its rallies up to 1938. We're going to visit the Congress Hall, the unfinished Congress Hall that you see behind me. We're also going to visit the Great Road and the Zeppelin Field where Hitler delivered his speech during the 1938 rally. And at the very end, we're going to visit another special site as well. This is Vic. Let's go for a very long walk. We have a lot to see and a lot to learn. Let's do it. Let's start our tour of the National Socialist Party rally grounds here in Nuremberg by looking at the most prominent landmark, the Congress Hall. This is the largest structure built by the National Socialists. Construction started in 1935 and it was never really completed because of the war. The outside consists of granite blocks that you see here. And it is in the shape of a U, the letter U. This is the side of the letter U that you see here. What we are going to do is we're going to walk around. And we're going to go inside the center of the letter U. You will see what I mean in just a second. Now this building, the Congress Hall, was designed by Ludwig and Franz Ruff, R-U-F-F. Everything else was designed by Albert Speer, the famous or infamous architect of the National Socialist Party, and later on the armaments minister during the war. This is one of the entrances to the Congress Hall, which is on the side of the letter U, if you can picture that. We're going to walk around and go inside. Come on. Again, if you can picture the letter U, I'm now right on top of the letter U, and there's a building here that was constructed as part of the Congress Hall. There's a space in the middle, so if you can imagine, we're going to enter through that space and go inside the letter U, and on the other side there's another similar building like this one, completing the imaginary letter U. These buildings here are used nowadays for, this one is used for the National Symphony Orchestra, and the other one is a museum on the other side. So we're going to walk around and go through the middle of letter U of the Congress Hall. And that's the building that we just passed. And once again, if you can imagine the letter U, now I'm entering through the center of the letter U, and I'm going to enter the main part of the Congress Hall built by the National Socialists. Now, they borrowed the design from the Colosseum in Rome. And for those of you that have been to the Colosseum, wait for a second and you will see what I mean. So the spectators would enter through this huge entrance here. And then, look at this. Tell me that this does not look like the Colosseum in Rome. course it's unfinished. The stands and the seating arrangements were never completed, but the brickwork all around was work in progress. Now it rises, the sides rise up to 35 meters in height. The plans were calling for a height of 70 meters, so it would have been twice as high as they are now. Over 50,000 people would be sitting here during the rallies. And again, that's twice the capacity of the Roman Colosseum. And there would have been a roof. The roof, of course, was never constructed because of the war. And somewhere around here, there was a special platform for Hitler. Right here in the middle, the platform was never constructed. And Hitler would be delivering his speeches from this platform, and everybody around the Congress Hall would have full visibility of him while he was speaking. Look at this. You can see it's a letter U-shaped complex with the two buildings on the side. That's one, and that's the other one that we just passed. In 1933, Hitler declared Nuremberg as the site for the National Socialist Party rallies. But why Nuremberg? Why this particular German city? That's because Nuremberg has a very significant symbolic meaning. You see, Nuremberg for many, many centuries was the site of the Emperor of the Holy Roman Empire, and this is where, actually 4 kilometers northeast from here in the castle of Nuremberg, this is where all the imperial states met under the authority of the Holy Roman Emperor. So what Hitler wanted to do by designating Nuremberg as the site of the National Socialist Party for the rallies, that is, that he was uniting the German people, the Germanic peoples, just like the Holy Roman Emperors did. And this is why Nuremberg was selected as the site for the rallies. And he designated Albert Speer to design this whole place here as the unique place for the National Socialist Party rallies. Now, this site, originally when it was designed by Albert Speer, included 11 square kilometers of buildings, stadiums, and other facilities as well. Very few of them remain, and one of them, the most prominent, is by far the Congress Hall that you're seeing here. And this here, ladies and gentlemen, what you see here is the so-called Great Road, designed by Albert Speer. Construction started in 1937 and it was completed in 1939. This road here is a little bit over 2 kilometers in length. That makes it a little bit over 1.2 miles in length. And it serves as a central axis through the whole complex here. Now I'm looking directly north. If you were to draw a line between where I'm standing at now, if you draw a line directly straight from where I am right now, you will end up at the Nuremberg Castle. And once again, this is why Nuremberg was selected as the site for the National Socialist Party rallies. By connecting this great road with a castle in Nuremberg, Speer was hoping to draw a symbolism between the National Socialist Party and the Holy Roman Emperor. Now, what was the purpose of this road so wide and so long? Well, the purpose was not only to serve as a central axis through the complex here, through this huge complex, but also this is where the Wehrmacht would perform their parades. Now, since the last party was in 1938, and since this road was completed in 1939, it was never used for a military parade. And these blocks of granite that you see here, gray and black, are the original blocks. There are 1.2 meters on each side. They are the original blocks. After the war, the Americans used this road as an airfield. And now it's being used as a car park or parking lot for the different events that take place occasionally in this area. And this is the Great Road. Now, just a little south of here, right there, if we can see the hints of the German stadium, another structure the Speer designed and which was never completed, right in front of the stadium facing the road, there would have been stands for Hitler, Himmler, and for the whole National Socialist Party leadership to attend the Wehrmacht parades. And here's a site that most likely you have seen in a variety of documentaries regarding the Second World War and the National Socialist Party rallies here in Nuremberg, especially the 1938 rally. This is the Zeppelin Field, named after Ferdinand von Graf Zeppelin, who landed his airship right here in 1909. This was the very first task of Albert Speer when he became the architect of the Third Reich, to design this field here for the mass rallies in Nuremberg. I'm walking now on the stands. These are 350 meters in length, just about 380 yards. So you can imagine here during the rally in 1938, thousands of people sitting here on the stands. And all around the field, over 150,000 soldiers listening to the speech delivered by Hitler. We're going to go to the place where Hitler stood, right up there, in just a couple of minutes. Now, the stands all around the field here are enclosed with barbed wire, and they're falling apart. Actually, grass is growing, if you can see them right there in the distance. So it's very unsafe to go there. We're going to limit ourselves to this area here. So this is the first site that Speer designed for the Third Reich, and this is the site used for the last National Socialist Party in 1938. Now, see that building right there, right behind the main stand? We're gonna go up there, but most likely you've seen a documentary of a swastika being blown up at the end of the Second World War. And that's the site right there. So you can imagine being here in 1938 with hundreds of thousands of people sitting on the stands all around, and soldiers feeling the inside of this vast area here. Now let's go up to the top and let's get a view of where the Nazi or the National Socialist Party leaders sat at while listening to the speech being delivered by Hitler up there. Come on. Now let's go a level higher from the stands. You see another set of steps. This is where the leaders of the party sat at while listening to Hitler delivering his speech. Incidentally, this building that you see here, designed by Speer, one of the books says that Speer got inspiration and design ideas from the altar in Pergamon. Pergamon was an ancient Greek city in today's Turkey. Let's go up one more level and let's get a view from up here and into the distance. From here you can see now this vast space, how large it is, how many people could fit in here. Well over 150,000 people. I'm right on top now. This is the other side of the stands that you see here, and I have full view of the whole area. Now let's go down the steps over here. And once again, imagine in 1938, these steps here were full of party leaders and ministers and so on. And that space that you see right there in front of me is the stand used by Hitler to deliver his speech, right there. Here's a view of the area. Now we're not gonna go on that platform. I refuse to do that for personal reasons. But a lot of people stand up here and they take their photographs. So you can imagine Hitler delivering his speech here in 1938. This is the view that he had in front of him. Over 150,000 people cheering. What a place. Really. Wow, what a day has been so far. Now, before we complete this documentary, I promised you I was going to show you the three main sites here in the south of Nuremberg, but I need to show you one more, one site that represents Albert Speer's megalomania, his desire to build huge structures for the National Socialists. Let's go and I will explain to you what I mean by that. Right there between the trees in the far distance and directly north from where I am right now is the Congress Hall we saw in the very, very beginning of this documentary. Here's a lake. Why is this lake so important? Well, in 1937, Albert Speer designed a huge stadium for this site that you see here. He called it the German Stadium. And he laid the foundation here in 1938. The stadium was going to be ready for the Congress of 1945. But it was not just a stadium. It was a huge structure of 800 meters in length going down that direction. Imagine a stadium 800 meters in length in the shape of an elongated horseshoe. This was going to be the top of the horseshoe. The stadium was going to be 450 meters wide and 100 meters high, and it would fit over 400,000 spectators. So Speer designed the stadium and ground broke here in 1938. This place here would be the top of the horseshoe that stands where I'm standing at right now. By 1939, when people constructing the stadium here, it started filling up with water, and throughout the years they had to pump the water out. And of course after 1945 they abandoned the project altogether, and now it's a lake. It is called Silver Lake. As a matter of fact, if I walk here, I'm walking on the stands right now. You can see the shape of the stadium materializing as I walk along the banks here. So the top of the stadium turned to be a lake. And what happened to the bottom of the stadium? Well, let's go check it out. So that's Silver Lake right there. That's the top of the horseshoe shaped stadium. And if I go down, now I'm walking along. Actually, let's walk inside the stadium right now. And in front of me, you see hills. Well, this place used to be all flat at one point in time. But what you see here is all the rubble from the medieval city of Nuremberg that was bombarded on January 2nd of 1945 and totally destroyed by the Allies. And all the rubble ended up over here, filling up this huge space that had been dug up to be used as the German stadium. Actually, if we walk through, you're gonna see I'm going uphill. And I'm walking now on the rubble of the city. Only future archaeologists can excavate this place and find medieval ruins here carried after the 1945 destruction of Nuremberg. You can see it even goes up higher. And at one point, this was all flat. This was going to be the main part of the stadium here. So much about Albert Speer's plans for a German stadium. Look at that, I'm going higher and higher. There are thousands of tons of rubble behind. Below my feet. And finally, I'm walking towards Silver Lake once again, and I want to show you a sign here. It says that swimming is forbidden, and that's because after the war, when this whole area was being cleaned up, every piece of armament and explosives that were found that were dumped in here. And this is an extremely poisonous and dangerous lake to even step in. Thus the sign here warning people not to swim in this lake. Well, it took over 4 hours to videotape the documentary that you just saw. If you have any comments about anything said or shown here in this documentary, please send me an email or comment in the space below. This is Vic. Thank you for joining me all the way from Nuremberg in Germany. Bye-bye.